The final item of business is a member's business debate on motion 18636 in the name of Claire Adamson on Macmillan Cancer Support's World's Biggest Coffee Morning. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put. Could I ask those members who wish to speak in the debate to press the request to speak buttons now? And I call on Claire Adamson to open the debate. Ms. Adamson, please.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. I'm delighted to be leading this debate this evening. Can I express my thanks to those colleagues who signed the motion, but also those who will speak in this evening's debate. It's not often we get to say we're speaking about a phenomenon, but that's the only way that I can describe Macmillan Cancer Support's World's Biggest Coffee Morning. It's in its 29th year of September fundraising events, and since 1990 it has raised over £200 million for practical, emotional and financial support to thousands of people in Scotland affected by cancer. Can I thank both Macmillan Cancer Support and the Scottish Government for their partnership in the Transforming the Cancer Care Programme. It will be a Scottish Government investment of £9 million, matched by Macmillan, that will ensure that every cancer patient receives emotional, practical and financial support by 2023. But tonight, Presiding Officer, our thoughts, it's all about our volunteers and fundraisers. The tens of thousands of people who participate in over 100,000 coffee mornings, events that happen in homes, workplaces, schools, churches, libraries, it seems to be anywhere where you can plug in a kettle. Can I take this opportunity to thank my Motherwell and Wishaw colleague Marion Fellows MP, who hosted a Macmillan coffee morning last Friday in our office complex. It was a fantastic event attended by council colleagues, by North Lanarkshire Provost Councillor Jean Jones, as well as the tenants from our building, members of the public and friends and family, and it raised £350 for Macmillan Cancer Support. Motherwell and Wishaw has a great tradition of supporting Macmillan Coffee Mornings and the work of Macmillan Cancer Support. Wishaw Macmillan professionals and practitioners were involved in one of the Transforming Care After Treatment pilot projects, which has informed the Transforming Cancer Care Programme. I was delighted to meet with Macmillan professionals during this pilot and see how those precious coffee morning pennies were being transformed into world-leading patient cancer journey interventions in my community. For example, £250 can give five people living with cancer an opportunity to attend a health or wellbeing event. £335 can pay for a Macmillan grant to allow a family affected by cancer to have a holiday, making most of their precious time and memories for the future. £546 could pay for a Macmillan social care worker for a week, helping patients, family members and carers manage the social and practical problems of living with cancer. And £1,023 could pay for a Macmillan nurse for a week, helping people living with cancer and their families to receive essential, expert, medical, practical and emotional support. Presiding Officer, I would also like to highlight a partnership between some of the North Lanarkshire and South Lanarkshire Council services with Macmillan Cancer Support, Culture NL, NL Leisure, South Lanarkshire Leisure and Culture, have joined forces with Macmillan Cancer Support to provide and improve cancer support services in the Lanarkshire area. They provide information and services, particularly in libraries throughout Lanarkshire, developing Macmillan's physical activity programme, Move More, and rolling out new volunteering opportunities. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Macmillan volunteers. There are many opportunities to be a volunteer, and skills of different types can be used to help people and the families dealing with cancer. People affected by cancer often feel isolated and alone, and crucially unable to access the right information and support at the right time. But volunteers can improve this situation. They need volunteers who are warm, supportive and non-judgmental, with great communication skills and a willingness to learn, and no previous experience is required. You could become a Cancer Information or Support Services volunteer, helping to distribute information about financial advice, physical activity opportunities, or accessing transport for appointments. A Gentle Movement volunteer will work with people affected by cancer in Chinese practices of breathing, physical activity, mental and spiritual awareness. A Move More motivator will meet and greet and provide a warm welcome supporting people throughout their journey. Or you could become a gardening volunteer, providing a warm welcome in the gardening group, supporting people to undertake gardening activities and develop valuable skills, and more importantly, to make a real difference for cancer patients, their families, and your communities. So there are many opportunities for people to help Macmillan Cancer Support. And of course, this partnership with North Lanarkshire and South Lanarkshire is delivered in our libraries. And I'm happy to say that both Wishaw Library and Motherwell Library in my constituency are supporting the Big Coffee Morning. Wishaw had their event on the 5th of September. Motherwell's yet to come, so an opportunity for people in the local community to attend the library on the 26th of September and take part in the world's biggest coffee morning. Presiding Officer, tonight could not pass without thank yous. A huge thank you in particular to the Macmillan professionals and Macmillan nurse practitioners who work within it or with a partnership with our NHS to support those who are suffering with cancer, their patients, their families, in delivering that vital support and information. And tonight is and should be all about thank yous. And I would like to put on record my thanks and the thanks of the whole chamber, I'm sure, to each and every person who has organised, participated in, or attended a Macmillan Coffee Morning this September. We should all raise a China cup or a mug in support of them. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much. I call Annie Wells to be followed by Rona Mackay. Ms. Wells.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer, and Claire Adamson for bringing this important topic to debate. It's always great when we can celebrate success stories in the Chamber, and Macmillan's Coffee Morning fundraiser is a huge success story. Now in its 29th year, the event, which will take place on Friday the 27th of September, is thought to be the charity's biggest ever event, with people all over the UK taking part. And it goes without saying that we've all probably been affected by cancer in some way, whether it's personally or someone close to you. Whatever the situation, a cancer diagnosis can change your life. It presents emotional, physical and financial burdens that many families find extremely difficult to cope with. The invaluable services that Macmillan provided to my family when my granny was diagnosed with cancer really helped us cope and understand. And I know that many families like mine will also want to thank Macmillan for all the amazing work they have done when at times it seems that your world is falling apart. In Scotland, it's expected that by 2020, around 35,000 people will be told they have cancer every year, a phenomenal figure. Although many cancer survival rates have improved over the last 20 years, the total number of people diagnosed with the disease is increasing year on year. Macmillan recognises how important it is to improve the lives of those with cancer and support them throughout their journeys. Amazingly, as already been noted by Claire Adamson, it has raised over £200 million since 1990, money that has gone towards research as well as the emotional, physical and financial supports that patients need. It's estimated that last year, nearly 2 million people received in-depth personal support from Macmillan professionals or services. And on that note, I want to also take the opportunity to thank the thousands of Macmillan nurses and health professionals and fundraisers who care for people living with cancer and support them through really difficult times, and the volunteers too. And it's through fundraising events that we can in turn support the work of Macmillan. And these events are by no means insignificant. Macmillan estimates that it raised an incredible £27 million from last year's Coffee Morning event. And next week, it's expected that thousands of people will again take part in the world's biggest coffee morning, making it the biggest yet. A couple of years ago, I hosted my own Macmillan coffee morning in my office in Maryhill in Glasgow, and I was genuinely very impressed with the resource kit that I was given, which contained bunting, cake decoration, stickers, and a collection box, and I felt heartened by the level of interest it received in the local community. Not only was it a great way to raise money, but it provided the perfect chance to catch up and meet new people over a cuppa and a slice of cake for a great cause. At a time when we are talking more and more about the importance of community-based events and tackling social isolation and loneliness, events like this are already invaluable. These events are easy to host, and I encourage anyone who's interested to go onto the Macmillan website and sign up. It doesn't need to be next Friday, and you can hold the event whenever is convenient for you. And to finish today, I'd like to again thank Claire Adamson for shining a light on the fantastic work that Macmillan does. The world's biggest coffee morning is the icing on the cake for a charity that works relentlessly to improve the lives of those with cancer. And I wish everyone hosting or attending a coffee morning next week the best of luck, and I sincerely hope the event is a massive success. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I call Rona Mackay to be followed by Monica Lennon. Ms. Mackay.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. It's my great pleasure to speak in this debate about the incredible service provided by Macmillan Cancer, and I thank my colleague Claire Adamson for bringing it to the Chamber. Presiding Officer, you can't put a value in the work done by Macmillan Cancer to help cancer sufferers and their families. All of us, whether directly or indirectly, have been or will be touched by cancer, and to know that there is comfort, advice and support is simply amazing. The public's biggest contribution in the fight against cancer is to raise awareness and raise funds for research and the invaluable work done by charities such as Macmillan Cancer. And one of the most pleasurable ways to raise money is by taking part in the world's biggest coffee morning. Who doesn't like a cuppa, cake and an atter with friends? My office, with absolutely no regard to my diet, have organised a coffee morning in my Kirkintilloch constituency office next Monday. There will be cakes, coffee, tea, dog biscuits for those who bring their four-legged friends, and I'm looking forward to it enormously. My own contribution, I feel bound to disclose, will come in a box provided by the local supermarket, as baking is definitely not my forte. However, Macmillan's partnership retailer, Marks & Spencer, are donating a percentage of cake sales to the charity, so that solves my conscience in some way. And Macmillan, as Annie Wells outlined, makes it so easy to host an event because they send you a full kit complete with bunting, posters and everything you need. Presiding Officer, the annual Coffee Morning is the biggest fundraising event held for people facing cancer. Last year, Coffee Mornings raised over £27 million, and since its small beginnings in 1990, when people donated the cost of a cuppa to Macmillan, more than £200 million has been raised for charity. That's simply incredible. That money helps everyone with cancer live life fully, as fully as they can, while being supported and cared for. Last month, the Scottish Government announced £18 million funding for the charity to provide one-to-one clinical support for people with cancer. This is an indication of just how important the work done by Macmillan Cancer and their fantastic volunteers is, and how far the charity has come over decades. The support Macmillan give is all-encompassing and is forever growing, whether it's financial, emotional or practical. In Stobhill Hospital, the nearest hospital to my constituency, they provided the transforming cancer care service mentioned by Claire Adamson. And they offered counselling and support to those who've beaten cancer but still need psychological and physical checkups to ensure they're coping. This is invaluable to people left with the trauma of diagnosis and to allay concerns of the cancer returning. Presiding Officer, I urge everyone to support the world's biggest coffee morning. So look out for your nearest event. There's sure to be one near you. Every sip of coffee, every bite of cake will go towards helping someone cope with the trauma of cancer. And that's how we can all do our bit to fight the scourge of cancer. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I call Monica Lennon, followed by Edward Mountain. Ms. Lennon.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And can I also begin by congratulating Claire Adamson for securing the debate, but also for her passionate opening speech. She's done her job already, because I didn't have the world's biggest coffee morning in my diary, which is a terrible confession for a health spokesperson to make. But that's been rectified now, so I hope we'll all say Friday, the 27th of September. And I think Rona Mackay has convinced me of that, because she's mentioned cake quite a lot. So I think we're all feeling a bit peckish now, but cancer is traumatic to start to pick up where Rona Mackay left off. It is traumatic, and there can't be a family in Scotland who hasn't been touched by cancer in some way. It's certainly been something that our family's had to cope with in the last couple of years, and I'm pleased that the outcome for my mum has been good. But without volunteers, particularly the fantastic transport service that we have in Lanarkshire, which I know that Claire Adamson is nodding along to because she'll know all about it. They're based in her constituency, I believe. Without those volunteers, to have those personal interactions, to have those one-to-one conversations that possibly you can't have with your nearest and dearest, it is so important. So I can't really think of a better cause, and I know that some of the recent announcements from Scottish Government together with Macmillan have been really, really positive, and it is so important because we do need to see investment in the cancer journey. Scotland's cancer care system has been facing unprecedented challenges, and we do a lot of work in this Parliament across the chamber, cross party, to look hard at how we can prevent cancer in the first place and to address some of the terrible health inequalities that we see. So the £18 million partnership between Macmillan Cancer Support and Scottish Government is certainly very welcome from these benches, because that wraparound support is vital, and we want to see the cancer journey being improved for everyone. Some of the background to that is worth mentioning, because the Cancer Experience Survey of 2018 found that 40% of cancer patients were not offered advice on how to access social security. Less than a third received a care plan. So from debt to depression, we know that people do need support, and there's a lot we can do to help people and support them through their cancer experience. And I was pleased to hear Claire Adamson mention colleagues in North Lanarkshire and South Lanarkshire as a fellow Lanarkshire MSP. This is really important, and people will drop into their library and to the leisure centres, even if they're not feeling physically ready to take part in activities. But the more we can do to make that accessible is really, really important. I think it's just worth to mention the ambition behind the Transforming Cancer Care partnership, which is to make sure that every cancer patient in Scotland by 2023 is reached or is realised, and to make Scotland the first country in the UK to fulfil its promise on personalised care. This is so, so important. The coffee morning is world leading, and I think it's a good opportunity for parliamentarians to come together with people in their community to enjoy that cuppa and a chat, but more importantly, to make our commitment clear to hopefully one day end cancer and do more on research, but for people who are going through it now, to make sure that they get the support that they need. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much. And I call Edwin Mountain, last speaker in the open debate. Mr. Mountain, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I'd like to thank Claire Adamson for securing this important debate. Let me start by saying that I'm sure everyone knows somebody close to them who has suffered by cancer. Over a three-year period, my father-in-law, my mother and my father died of cancer. So this is an issue very close to my heart, and one I take a great interest in, and why I support Macmillan Cancer Support. Indeed, Presiding Officer, I should also register an interest at this point to declare that my wife is chair of a local Macmillan Cancer Fundraising Support Group. So nothing drives me more than supporting this charity, especially as my wife never fails to remind me that as she supports me, I should always support her. And Presiding Officer, I do, knowing that I will also not only have to sign up to the coffee morning, but also to sign up to the Macmillan Fun Run on Speyside each year. I know which one I prefer. One is good for my waist and one is not. But let me be clear, if these fundraising groups that allow Macmillan to help fund cancer sufferers and the work, and it is now more important than ever. Every 2 minutes, someone in the UK is diagnosed with cancer. Advances in medicine have meant that people with cancer have added years to their lives, or even get the all clear. Currently, there are 25 million people living with cancer across the UK today, but thanks to better treatment, this number is expected to rise to nearly 4 million by 2030. That means we need more than ever the work that Macmillan nurses do, and therefore fundraising must go on. But I know this charity will rise to that challenge, as it is blessed to have some of the most hard-working fundraising groups across the country. Last year, as we heard, the world's biggest coffee morning raised over 1.9 million across Scotland and over 150,000 in the Highlands and Highland region. And let's not forget that since 1990, the world's biggest coffee morning has raised nearly 200 million. That's an astonishing sum. And fundraising isn't, though, just limited to coffee mornings. Over the course of the year, I have to remind you, there's lunches, jazz events, and fun runs, to name but a few. Local committee groups pour so much energy into organising the events, and we as a parliament should do all that we can to celebrate their efforts. For example, the Space Eye Committee Group recently handed over a cheque for £10,000 to Macmillan. And that wouldn't be possible without devoted volunteers. Volunteers like Marjorie Walker and Margaret Shepherd, who joined the group just after it was established in the 1970s and have served on the committee for over 45 years. That's a lot of coffee mornings, presiding officer. And while their service isn't special, it's not extraordinary, as there are a number of equally committed groups and advocates across the Highlands and Islands region. Presiding officer, I would urge everyone to support Macmillan's World's Biggest Coffee Morning this September and take this time to celebrate the fundraising efforts of local Macmillan groups across Scotland. I know I will, and I know my waste will suffer. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mountain. I call on Graeme Day to close to the Government Minister, please.
Presiding Officer, I want to start by echoing the comments of others and congratulating and thanking Claire Adamson for lodging this motion, enabling us, all of us, to engage in a debate on this important subject. Let me also explain why I'm responding on behalf of the Government. Much to her regret, the Cabinet Secretary for Health and Sport is engaged on other significant government business and therefore unable to be here. I do hope, however, to be a worthy, or perhaps at least adequate, substitute. Today's debate gives us the opportunity to not only highlight some of the fantastic work of Macmillan Cancer Support, as members have done, but to recognise also our collective achievements thus far and consider the road ahead, to take stock but also to look to the future. There are few among us that don't know someone close that's been touched by cancer. Indeed, Edward Mountain, Monica Lennon and Annie Wells shared their own family experiences. There are currently around 220,000 people living with the impact of a cancer diagnosis in the country, and this is set to reach 343,000 by 2030. It can be a devastating disease which tests all aspects of a patient's life. It can also have a pronounced impact on the lives of close family. It's therefore of the utmost importance that the care we offer patients helps them, not just physically, but with the mental, emotional, financial and wider life impacts of the disease. That's why the Scottish Government's recently announced exciting £18 million partnership with Macmillan Cancer Support is so important. This transforming cancer care programme makes Scotland the first country in the UK to offer every single cancer patient guaranteed emotional, practical and financial support. The First Minister and the Health Secretary announced this partnership at the Beats and West of Scotland Cancer Care Centre in Glasgow at the end of August. Having the privilege to visit a life-saving centre like the Beats and the opportunity to speak with cancer patients drove home to them the real-life positive effect this initiative will have for so many people, not just the patients, but as I say, their loved ones too. As is the case with many new initiatives, for patients and clinicians to get the most benefit out of this partnership, it will require a cohesive uptake from health boards, local authorities and the wider third sector. By ensuring patients are signposted to the appropriate resources where required, we can begin to strategically assess and meet the non-clinical needs of people affected by cancer and begin to alleviate stress on other areas of our NHS, allowing clinicians to focus on treating patients. It's vital all involved, IGBs, Health Board and the third sector, really unite to make the most of this pioneering partnership. Alongside this, the Health Secretary has signalled a refresh of the Scottish Government's £100 million cancer strategy. Much has been achieved under this strategy, but as research and technology advance, so should our thinking and our focus. The refresh will allow us to realign our attention to the areas of cancer that need it most. In progressing this work, the Cabinet Secretary has committed to involving the Cancer Coalition. Indeed, we have already, I understand, initiated that discussion with them. There are, of course, ways in which we as individuals can demonstrate our support for this cause. As all of our contributors tonight have noted, Friday the 27th of September will mark the 29th annual Macmillan World's Biggest Coffee Morning. The proceeds of this will continue to help Macmillan support many cancer patients across Scotland. And as we've heard, the Coffee Morning started life in 1990 as a small gathering, and over the years it's grown larger and larger, to the point we're all told it's raised over £200 million to help cancer patients. A phenomenon, as Claire Adamson rightly described it. One of the main reasons the Coffee Morning is so successful is because of how simple and easy it is for anyone and everyone to get involved. For that reason, like others have done, I'd encourage every one of my colleagues around me in the chamber today either to host their own event on the 27th or support one already being delivered, because every single penny that's raised helps. In conclusion, Presiding Officer, I think I speak for everyone in the chamber here today when I say that we cannot thank enough each and every one of the extraordinary staff, nurses and volunteers of Macmillan who work tirelessly to help cancer patients. Rona Mackay was right when she said, "You cannot put a value on the work of Macmillan." It's these individuals that make the biggest difference in supporting people through what can be some of the most challenging times in their lives. I also want to acknowledge the role of their families here, both in providing love and support of their own, and then again, in many cases, fundraising for Macmillan, either through hosting a coffee morning of their own or by other means of the type that Edward Mountain highlighted. As I mentioned earlier, we still have much to do in our fight against cancer, but through innovative technology, new advances in medicine, a determined workforce of dedicated staff, and those selfless acts of charity we continue to see, I'm certain that we're on the right path. Our thanks again go to Macmillan for the huge part they play in this. Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I close this meeting of Parliament.